Dear friends, this is Jiří Dufek on the Rajah channel, and today I will show you the game Curb of Solak from Jerusalem 2017. And the main question from my side is the Slav defense dead or not? And I think that this game is a very good starting point for claiming that Slav defense is dead. Of course, this is slight exaggeration from me, but as I will show you, things are not so simple. Okay, let's start. D4, D5, C4, C6, Knight F3, Knight F6, Knight C3, DC4, which is classic Slav defense, which was firstly played in World Championship match, I think, between Alich and Ewe. But in fact, the line is, of course, much more older. And A4, Bishop F5, Knight E5. And in this video, I will start with move Knight BD7, which is probably today's main line. And E6 we will cover later. Knight C4, Knight B6, Knight E5, A5, which is a basic position. And the main setup for White is G3, Bishop G2, short castle, with something like Catalan type of position, probably with a small advantage for White, or you know, maybe better with a very playable game for both players. And I think that Black is very happy to see this setup, because he has a very stable situation on queen side. Mainly, b4 square is very important in the long run, and Black is in good shape, I think, in this line. But in Curb of Solak, White played very surprising move h4, and made a basic question: what should Black do with his bishop on f5? And in game, he played knight bd7, and I think this move probably is not so best. Let's look on other continuation. Probably we can start with something like g6, which was played in Aronian against in game Aronian Anand in Leuven 2016, with idea to transpose to some strange greenfield defense. But after h5, g takes, e4, Bishop g6, Bishop e3, e6, and Bishop d3. We see that White has a very nice center, and permanent question is, what should Black do with his king on e8? Because on the queen side there is no way how to move this king, and on the king side he will be very very weak. Black plays knight bd7. And after knight takes, queen takes f3, bishop g7, queen d2 short castle, knight e2, rook fd8, bishop c5. We see same scenario. White has very nice center, and his bishop is very big piece. In fact, it is just a big pawn in this position. And in game was played c5, bishop b5, queen c7, rook c1, and with the advantage for White. And the bishop on g6 is absolutely prospectless, because there is no way how to activate it. Another move after h4 was played in game Blubaum Michalik Zlerta 2015, and Michalik played knight fd7. And probably this is just some kind of mistake, because after e4, knight takes e5, ef, knight ec4, h5. We see another problem with the black position, and this is just absolutely dead bishop on f8. There is no simple way how to activate it. g6 is impossible, and e5 was played in a game. After fe, queen e7, we see that black will have a very weak pawn on e6. After bishop c4, knight c4, short castle, long castle, rook e1, f takes e6. Blue bomb play knight e4, which is still a very good move, but in fact queen g4 was crushing, not only threatening rook takes e6, but even bishop g5 is on the list, and black has no defense in this position, because after rook d6, solving both problems, bishop g5 or e6 threat, then d5 is crushing, absolutely blowing black center. Cd5, b3, knight b6, knight b5. Of course, rook cannot go back for rook e6, then black is forced to play knight c6 and allows fork on a7, but even in this position, white is not forced taking exchange, but simply can play bishop f4, and rook a and knight a7 is still threatening, rook a7 too, and then rook takes e6, and probably black can resign and look at the board and piece on f8 and h8. They are very, very bad pieces. And after queen g4, we can try queen d7, but it's very similar, because bishop g5, rook e8, and d5. After cd, knight takes d5, queen takes d5, rook a d1, and we see queen is attacked, and there is no simple way how to defend it. And after knight e5, rook a c1 check, king b8, queen f4, and black cannot cover knight e5 and queen d5 at one moment. And the last move after h4 is, and probably its best, is e6. And after f3, h6, e4, bishop h7, we see that this bishop will have very hard life, because there is no diagonal opened, because pawn on e4, and activated this bishop over g8, it will take a lot of time. Bishop e3, knight fd7, knight d3, bishop d6, which looks quite normal. And in this position, Ding Liren against Ma in China 2015, Ding Liren played knight e2, covering everything in the center. And after rook c8, he played rook c1, not only taking under c5 under control, but maybe planning knight c5 in a very near future. But after short castle, queen b3, king h8, with idea to play bishop g8. Now there is main question, how to develop bishop f1 and rook h1. And Ding Liren found a simple solution. He played king f2. And he will see the best squares for the bishop in the very near future. And after bishop e7, he played g3, covering f4 square and preparing knight f4. And then bishop e2 or bishop g2, bishop h3, everything is possible. And rook hd1, or even there is g4 and g5 with attack on a kingside. And black has very slight advantage. The last move, which just only transposed to this line, is h6. After this move, white simply play f3, and after knight fd7, e4, bishop h7, knight d3, e6, bishop e3, bishop d6, we are back in the 9e6 line. Just return to back to game. Knight bd7 was played, queen b3, knight takes e5, d takes e5, knight d7, e4, bishop e6, queen b7, everything is forced. Of course, b4 square is very big advantage for black, but it's very hard to place any piece of the square and in this position, black has two main moves. First is rook b8, after queen a7, knight takes e5. Just taking back pawn, and I think in this position, which is very non-standard, a very safe way how to place bishop e2. Simply try to finish development, and after g6, because bishop on f8 is very big problem, then h5, opening or trying open to h5. After rook g8, knight d1, and preparing bishop d2 with question to a5 pawn, and because there will be probably no short castle for white, then probably king will make a walk over f1 to g2 after preparation with g3. And I think white is slightly better. In a game, after queen takes b7, knight takes e5 was played, which is very good move. And in this position, white played bishop f4, which is an interesting move, but white had a very interesting f4 to his disposal. Attacking knight, and after rook b8, queen a7, knight d7, and f5. And we see that, in fact, white developed just only queen on previous square on a7 and knight on c3, and all other moves were played by pawns. Looks like some study or something like this. And after bishop b3, bishop f4, attacking rook, and probably in this position, black has nothing better than sacrifice exchange with e5. After fe, bishop e6, bishop takes b8, knight takes b8, and rook d1, and white is exchange up for just nothing, just exchange. But his pawns looks very strange. Yeah, there is, in fact, every pawn is very weak. And not only pawns, but g4 square and g3 square is weak too. But it's not so easy for black to use these weak squares and weak pawns. I think that white is slightly better. Probably you should check this with the computer. But in game was played bishop f4, and surprisingly it was scored very, very quickly, because black played some inaccurate moves. After rook b8, queen a6, rook e8, queen e2, queen b8, just activating queens, covering knight on e5 and attacking pawn on b2. And after h5, in this position, black had very shocking move, which give him a very strong counterplay. And this shocking move is g5, sacrificing pawn. And after bishop g5, rook g8, bishop f4, bishop g7, rook d4, rook d1, and queen b4, we see very strong bishops. Which are looking on queen side and quite weak of b2 pawn. And in this position, black has a very nice counterplay. But he played, after h5, he played knight d3 check. And he thought, after queen takes f4, he got two bishops, which should be very good compensation for his lack of development for a while. But after g3, queen d6, of course, exchanging queens, it should be very good for black. Queen e3, queen b4, attacking pawn, bishop g2, of course, after queen takes b2, short castle with terrible compensation for a pawn. He made a big blunder. He played bishop c4, trying to stop white short castle. But now e5 was played and black resigned because there is no simple way how to defend the pawn on c6 with the fork. And after rook c8, which looks quite normal, there is rook h4. And because this pin, then black is losing a piece. And this is just after e5. Solak, who was 2600 rated in this game, he resigned and I think lost in the Slav defense in just 22 moves. It's shocking for everyone. If I will try to make some small conclusion, the main line, knight bd7, I think is just under pressure with knight c4, knight b6, knight e5, a5, and now just h4. And probably the best way how to play is to agree with small positional disadvantage after e6, f3, h6, e4, bishop h7, bishop e3, knight fd7, knight d3, bishop d6. Because this looks like more or less quite normal Slav defense, but of course the position is quite non-standard. White is not forced, or even he just only occasionally make a castle, a short castle. Very often he plays king f2 and g3 and then bishop e2, just covering everything in the center. And I think even in this case, white has a slight advantage. Thank you for watching and see you next time.